Hey guys, this is Nefarious411 and welcome to episode 83 of my modded survival series. In the previous few episodes, we've been playing around with PneumaticCraft and we did some reorganization last time, and we eventually came up with the five air compressors that you see here, and they are all behind the door. I have some pressure plates with me just to open this up. Down here, being able to shut off whenever it's about 4.5 or 5, pretty close to 5. I haven't had any problems with it blowing up on me, thank goodness, but I still need to keep an eye on it just in case. I'm hoping that it doesn't blow up on me, but I am going to grab these pressure plates right now because these are the Ender IO pressure plates, and if you take a look at the other recipe for that, it's basically just 2 dark steel and it creates a pressure plate. And the nice thing about the Ender IO ones is I can jump over here and throw these into the painting machine. It looks like I already had the marble that I wanted, so this will be pretty nice because this will just blend in with the floor. There we go. It raises it up just a little bit, but it's at least the same design. So I have this little maintenance area. I might clean this up at some later time so that it's not just stone back there and I keep running into that. So today, I actually want to play around with creating some plastics from the other liquids that we have. And looking at Wayla, you can see that we have about 96 buckets of the LPG, which is the liquid plastic something. I'm not sure what LPG stands for. LPG, liquid plastic something. I am not exactly sure. Oh well, but that is going to allow us to actually create the plastics needed. So what I want to do is, first I have this thermopneumatic processing plant, and that's going to be the basis for creating plastics from the liquid LPG. So the other thing that I need, if I look at PneumaticCraft, there's actually a couple of things that I need. One of them you're already familiar with, and that's going to be the vortex coil. As soon as I find it in NEI. I'm not seeing it for some reason. Oh, it's because it's not the same color that I was expecting. So vortex tube, I think I said coil, it's actually tube, and a plastic mixer. And it doesn't look like I have the other glass for this, so let me go ahead and create some glass, get that going. There we go, there's 2. One more. That'll give us the plastic mixer. Nice. All right, so now we just need to be able to hook this into the network, and I am not exactly sure which one I want to do. I don't really want it on this side because that is basically throttled down. There's still a little bit of pressure that's going through that. I wasn't able to get it to shut off all the way, but if you see, whenever I flip that switch, it throws pressure back in here, which turns on these vortex tubes, which will essentially just produce heat on that side. So what I want to do is probably first turn off my Wayla because it gets in the way. I might want to just play around with it first, just to see what's going to happen once I hook this up. So I might just tie into the line down here for now. And let me go ahead and grab a few pipes. And I think I have the other pneumatic pipes in here. Are they called pipes? Tubes? There we go, tubes. There we go, cool. And I will need that LPG, but I'm not sure how I'm going to do that yet. So what I want to do is probably place the plastic mixer there, and I don't think this requires any kind of connection to the pneumatic pressure network, so that one should be fine. It does look like I have some user interface here. And it's hovering around room temperature right now, so it probably needs to have something to do with temperature. And let me put this one here, and this guy probably right there. Nope. I need to swap that around because the heat side is going to go on this, I believe. And I should be able to pop down, I guess, in the back now. A couple of these tubes. I'm gonna hook up that one first. And now this guy. And that should start the temperature here. So I just want to get a general sense of what this is going to do. And it kind of looks like this is going to require some sort of pressure, but it doesn't look like it actually uses the pressure, does it? Yeah, it does. This machine requires or produces heat. Heat can be applied by placing a block that generates heat next to this machine. Think of a vortex tube, fast but requires power, but also lava, slow, and torches, very slow. Oh, okay, so you can put other types of heat around it. So this, the temperature appears to go up, and I assume that I could just use any bucket. So let me go ahead and grab a bucket of LPG. And see if I can add it to this guy. And you can see that it creates nothing right now. How do I make plastics? Plastic. White plastic, I guess. No. Is there like a generic plastic? These are all showing the seed approach, but I don't think I really want the seed approach. Doesn't look like I have any user interface on that. I wonder, does this require some sort of water or something? Or maybe it's coal. I think I remember something about coal. That did something to the temperature. Or maybe I just have to wait for the temperature to get to a certain degree. And right now it's at 89. So it's slowly increasing. So what I want to do, yeah, this doesn't look like it's doing anything either. What I want to do, there's a couple of things with PneumaticCraft that might be able to help me. And those are called heat sinks. And basically heat sinks, it disperses heat into the air, only connects with the block it's on. When an air grate tube module is pointed at it, its effectiveness is increased greatly. Air grate tube module. Let me go ahead and create one of these. I might create a couple of them. And air grate tube module. This module will attract or repel any entity within its range. That seems kind of weird. Okay, so I need bars. Let me go ahead and craft up a few more of those. There we go. And let's see what this guy does. Let me come over here real quick, see if there's anything in here. Oh, there we go. So there is liquid plastic that is going inside this thermopneumatic processing plant. And if I were to put more coal in there, and it's because it's above the boiling point, it is able to convert the LPG into this liquid plastic. Nice. So it has 700 millibuckets now, and it goes down 100 millibuckets. So we have 4,000 here, put one piece of coal, and that increases by 1,000. Okay, so basically every 100 millibuckets is a full bucket of liquid plastic. So that is good to know. And I think it's because it uses the coal to produce all of that. So let me go ahead and put the rest of the coal in here that it needs to convert all of that into liquid plastic. And one more. There we go. And that gives us a full 10 buckets of liquid plastic. And I guess I need to pipe this out. And I'm just going to use Ender.io for this. Probably as good as any. So let me go ahead and extract. That should fill up this guy, and you can see that I have liquid plastic in there. And it does have the temperature pretty high on the hull. And I don't think it's going to allow me to create any plastics while this temperature is up. So one thing that I could do to take care of that, I might want to swap these guys. Well, I can't exactly swap it, can I? And that's exactly why I wanted it in the middle of the floor here, because I didn't know which side I was going to need things on, and I have a general idea. Yes, I'm going to lose some pressure there. I should have hit the bottom pipe first. I could put a vortex tube right next to this guy. And let me put that there. Oops. Keep doing that. Okay, so how do I place it? This is not wanting to place for me. There we go. And if I swap this side, this should put the cold side on the plastic mixer. And a little bit of tubing. Oop, wrong one. I keep forgetting the connections on the back of this guy. Here we go. And that should put the cold side on this. And we should be able to see the temperature in the hull going down, which is exactly what we're seeing right here. Down to 92. This is not going very fast. I think I ran out of space. Well, this actually seems to have some sort of effect on it. So I might put a couple of these fans on it, or fins, or whatever they're called, heat sinks, and that should dissipate some of the heat into the air. And it doesn't look like it's going down much faster. I think I may have needed it on that side over there, but kind of in the way of the air compressor. Well, I guess I could use the other sides. Let me try that real quick. Let me change sides on this. See if that has any effect whatsoever. There we go. Flop that guy right there. And that's one reason why I like to have a little bit larger areas to play around with, just to make sure that I have some leeway with any kind of experimentation that I have. And this is down to 71, 70, 69, so it is going down a little bit faster. Not sure if that's working. It does change color, so it must be doing something. I might want to create a couple more of those heat sinks. Heat sink. Air grate tube module. I forgot about that guy. Let me see what that does. Air grate tube module. Whoa. That is lifting me up in the air. That is kind of cool. So I guess it's sort of like a fan, and it does look like it's blowing heat or something into the air. That looks kind of interesting what it's doing there. It's got these little particle effects, or it's creating a grid. Well, the temperature is way down on this now. It is almost down to room temperature, and I'm wondering, do I need something in here to convert it? I mean, it looks like there's slots for RGB, so I think it might require some color to change it. So let me try that real quick. Let me grab some lapis. Throw that in there and see, will I get a blue piece of plastic? Nope. I think that just fills up its blue inventory. Yeah, it looks like there's a little gauge right here for the RGB. So let me go ahead and get that out so it doesn't use it all. So let me grab some red. And this is going to be some rose red and green. Cactus green. There we go. That way, I guess you can choose any color that you want. So here we go. If I were to select lime, lock selection, lime. Ah, there we go. Okay. So that did convert all of my liquid plastic into actual plastic sheets. So that was kind of interesting. I guess you do need these slots filled in order to create all of the colors that you need from all of the 16 different types of colors. So that's pretty interesting. I don't know if I like the lock mechanism, because I don't really want to convert them all into the same color. I wasn't really paying attention to see if it was creating one on a per click. So that might be kind of interesting. I do think that I need to clean this area up, however. Need to find a permanent home for it. So let me go ahead and do that, and I will be right back. Alright guys, I am back, and a little bit of time has passed in between. I decided to go ahead and reorganize some of this stuff, because I wanted to go ahead and put the, thermopneumatic processing plant there, and as well as the plastic mixer. Figured this is probably a good spot for it. I could move it later, and I probably will. This seems to be a very iterative process, but I did want to go through the things that I have changed since, and one of the things that I changed was I added some of these extra pressure gauge tube modules. That way I didn't have to always come in here to check the other pressure of the system as a whole. I decided to put it out here so that I can easily see it, and I have two other gauges, and both of those have a shutoff. The bottom one is specifically to the refinery units here, is basically turning on or off the airflow into these vortex tubes. But then this one is like the main shutoff of everything over there. And even down here, I have a shutoff for the thermopneumatic processing, the coil here, or tube here, just to make sure that I had some way of dealing with it appropriately. So, let me show you inside of here. I made a little maintenance area. And let's go ahead and look at this real quick. Figure I should explain it a little bit before proceeding on to the next part. So I have this unit the same as it was before. This still shuts off the air compressors whenever it gets to a certain point. And this is basically the main line up. So this is where the air pressure is coming out of from the compressors into this main area. I don't have anything that shuts it off going that direction, and right now the only thing that's that direction is the pressure chamber. But if I go up here, all that is doing, if I pull out my wrench, we can see through these facades. This pipe is only going to the pressure gauge module. That way we can see what's going on. That's all it's doing. But then over here in this direction, I have the main shutoff here, and this is to shut off everything on this side. And that's with the red channel. And you can see that the red channel is tied to that lever at the top. And I have labeled that using the fancy signs as shutoff. for a lack of a better name. I'll probably figure out a better name for it later. But then if we come through here, we have a diversion where one is the pressure tube that just goes up to this little gauge right there so that we can get a readout of everything over here. And then I also have one of these regulators here on the green channel, and that is going to be, if I look down there, connected to that lever, which that should essentially just shut this off. And this is using a strong signal on both of these. And that is just going to the two tubes for the refinery. So that is pretty nice. And we can come over here. Oh, I never actually connected that. Let me just double check to make sure that I have everything connected on this side. And this one is going to the vortex tube on the other side of this cover here, and that's controlled by this regulator and by that lever. So it's a little bit more complicated than it was before, but I kind of like that in regards to the PneumaticCraft stuff, is that it's kind of always changing. It's a very iterative process, and I really like that. So let me go ahead and turn on the main area, and you can see that the pressure from this network is starting to balance out with this network. And I also have the refinery turned off. It should have been off. Is that going up in temperature? No, it's not. I'm not sure why I'm getting pressure there. That should not show a pressure. Oh, that is why. It's because I put the regulator going this direction, but it should have been for this one too. I might have to change that. So let's change that real quick. And I'm just going to do something gross right now. I'm just going to put some covers in between just to prevent the airflow. And you can see now this side is diverted around this little corner for the pressure gauge module. And that should, well, it does look like it's going down, but it's got pressure on its own, just holding into the pipe. It'll eventually go down, but we'll have to wait for that a little bit. So let's go ahead and come over here. Well, this is going up for some reason. Maybe because I diverted that and it put all of the pressure that was currently in here, and now it's going over there. That is kind of interesting. I guess it was because of this little connection and bypassing the regulator just for a little bit. And these should actually be going down in temperature, and it does look like the hot side is going down, so that is very good. And I do have the ability to put these heat sinks here, and that should considerably change the temperature. So let me go ahead and turn that on again. And this turns on the refinery. And you can see that now the heat sink is actually taking a bluish color because we connected it to the cold side. So it actually makes the hot side a little bit hotter, actually. So you can see that the temperature jumped up way above 150 this time, so we should be able to process the fluids a little bit faster now. And it seems to be climbing, hovering around 158, 159 now. And this is doing pretty well. So let me go ahead and turn that back off, because I kind of want the air pressure to be put over here. And I kind of hooked this up a little bit. You might notice that I did disconnect these pipes here, because I do need to pipe the liquid plastic into here. But before I do that, I want to change my filter, because this one is going to start receiving on the insert side. I want to filter on LPG and just take a bucket of LPG, put it on here, and this is going to be the whitelist. That way only LPG is going to go into the thermopneumatic processing plant. We do have the ability to take any of these other fluids into there and convert them into the other fluids, but I'm not doing that right now. I'm just going to use the other refinery. If worse comes to worse, we could take like the kerosene and convert it as appropriate, but not too worried about it. So what I want to do is auto extract. I do want this to always be active, because it'll get the redstone signal there, and I don't want that to interfere. And this will convert into I just realized that I don't have a an AE cable over here, because I need coal. But let me deal with that here in a second. So I need to basically put the liquid plastic in here, but I don't have any liquid plastic at the time being. So what I probably want to do, I don't think I can scoop it out with a bucket, but let me go ahead and turn this on. And that fluid shouldn't go anywhere because there's nowhere in the network that liquid plastic can go. Whoa, that temperature went way up. All right, so yeah, I do need some source of coal in here. So let me get a little bit, enough for maybe a bucket. Can I do this? New. Doesn't look like I can grab a bucket from there. How am I gonna do this cleanly? These are all inserts, so the extract active with signal. And so none of these should. Let me just make sure that this is only insert, just to make sure that these don't pull out whenever I'm not wanting them to. There we go. Let me just put that one insert for now. All right, so the only thing that's extracting should be that guy. So let me come over here, grab another tank. That one has stuff in it. Let's just do a very tiny tank. That is fine. Probably need to get more glass going here in a little bit. There we go. And that should be enough. Let me just pop that guy down, grab a bucket, and now I should be able to turn this guy on and say that I want to insert only liquid plastic. And hopefully, if I did this correctly, as soon as I put coal in here, this should extract that liquid plastic and put it in here, and it is, which is very, very good. And can I just do like a black plastic? And there's my black plastic. Nice. So single button press will give you that one. So that is pretty nice. So now it's just a matter of getting the charcoal over here to auto create. I'm not sure if I need to do that, but it might be kind of interesting. And as you can see, because I have the hot side on that side, and this is what keeps it up temperature in order to melt, or I say melt, but convert the LPG and coal into the other liquid plastic, the cold side is actually on the plastic mixer. So let me just double check to see if this will keep the whole temperature down. It should. I mean, right now it's negative 35 degrees Celsius. It seems to be getting a little bit colder for some reason. So yeah, we shouldn't have any issue at all coming in here, clicking on any of these colors. Of course, I need to pull one out before I click on the next. But that converts immediately, and we don't have the extra hull heat that will prevent the plastic from melting, or from hardening. Let me try that again. Keeping the liquid plastic from hardening into normal plastic sheets. So we are good with that. So what I want to do is first probably convert this back here. And I should be able to connect that guy and dump the contents into here. Maybe. Ooh, wrong way. Wrong way. Can I extract always? Or is this guy full? Oh, that guy's full. All right, so I probably want to stop this guy. Just temporarily. Let's create some plastics just to get all of the liquid plastic out of this, because I don't really want this here. It was only temporary so that I can get a bucket, which reminds me I should probably right-click the bucket to get rid of that guy and put my LPG back, and we are golden. So let me go ahead and shut the system down. And I could probably go ahead and do my main shutoff. Let me go ahead and run some ME conduit over there, and I should be ready to start the next part. All right, I am back, and I did run the ME cable. I decided to just pull it off of this and run it over here. Now I have an export bus on this guy. I forgot to actually load it up with coal. So let me go ahead and grab a piece of coal so that I can tell it to export coal into the thermopneumatic processing plant. It's not going to do much right now because it doesn't have any heat or pressure, but I also added an import bus on this side so that it'll be able to pull the plastics as it's needed. So for example, if I needed two green plastics, I can just go ahead and do that. Right now it's kind of slow. It just pulls them out pretty slow. I know that I'm kind of out of time for today, but I do want to at least start the next part of this plan, and I want to get into the assembly tables, because in order to get some of the more advanced things, we need to be able to use the assembly platform and these lasers and stuff like that. But in order to do that, we need the unassembled PCB, and obviously we can't create it with the arms and all of that yet, because obviously we need this, so it's a little cyclic dependency. But we are able to create one of these empty PCBs with some green plastic, iron ingot, and then by using the etching acid, we're able to create one of these unassembled PCBs. So we do need to create some etching acid. I do have the things needed for it, which are two green plastic, two spider eyes, two rotten flesh, two gunpowder, and a bucket of water. And that will all get pulled in there. And if you remember, right now I have the item filter on a compressed block. Probably want to keep that just until we get the etching acid. And this is going to be short-lived. We don't need to do this long-term, and this is really slow. but as soon as it's all in there, we create the etching acid. We only need it enough to create the initial assembly units, because obviously, once we have this line of machines, we're able to create the PCBs no problem at all. So then it would make it where we don't need that etching acid anymore. So what I want to do is change that to... can I just... There we go. Cool. And now I can change it back to the block of iron as soon as that's out. Let me go ahead and grab that etching acid. And I should probably just put this over here for now. And... you gotta be careful, because if you step in this, you'll actually take damage because it is acid. So what we want to do first, I want to actually create one of these empty PCBs. And to do that, it's a crafting recipe of green plastic and a compressed ingot. So what I want to do first, I probably need to import all of this into my network. I guess the quickest way. Oops. Just break the chest and throw it in there. Maybe not the quickest way, but it's definitely an easier way. There we go. That's probably good. Let me go ahead and repair the hole in the wall. So let's go ahead and create a recipe for that. We want one of these guys, and I think it was a green plastic. There we go. And for now, let's just say it creates this. I know it's kind of weird, but I will change the recipe as soon as this is done, just to get my initial one going. So let me go ahead and come up here, add my pattern, just temporarily, and I should be able to grab my terminal. Grab some marble. Maybe that was a bad choice because I have so many of those. There we go. Just create one, and that should at least put the things in here that I need. Yes, again, it's kind of weird. I just didn't want to have to do this manually because I need one of these items in order to say that I have it. There we go. It created that, so we should be able to change this and change it back. Can I just grab that? Nope, I can't. All right, so let me grab a PCB just to make sure that we have it, oops, in the filter here. I was wondering if my magnet was going to work. There we go. And let's come over here. Ah, forgot to grab my pattern. Let's just grab that pattern out of here real quick, just so that we can change it to the appropriate pattern. So what you want to do, I guess I'm getting a little bit of lag right now. Clear that recipe, put the encoded pattern here, and let's go ahead and change this to that. Nice, re-encode, and now we can see that now it creates the empty PCB with that recipe. So now, oh, I did not mean to do that. Nope, that's fine. I thought I hit the other pattern, but let me go ahead and do this again. And I can craft a PCB. There we go. And that should put a compressed iron and a green piece of plastic in there. I really want this to go a little bit faster at some point. Come on, there it goes, and it's already pulled out, and I should have my additional PCB in here, and there it is. Nice. So in order to create the unassembled PCB, we need to put it in etching acid, throw an empty PCB that has been exposed by UV light. So does that mean that I need to do this in a UV? So let's go ahead and look at that real quick. UV box, light box. That's pretty simple. Yeah, let's go ahead and create one of those guys. Apparently, because the progress bar here, we actually need a PCB that's been exposed to the UV stuff. So let's go ahead and create one of these guys. And do I have those? And I do. And this just uses the same pressure system as everything else. And for now, I'll probably just hook it up straight to the main network here. There we go. And it is balanced out. I should be able to put the PCB in here. And it's at 1%. So this is going to be slow. No problems. It's got a decent amount of pressure. It's just going to take a while. So let me go ahead and run that through. Let's just take a look real quick before I end it off for today. I need some other things for this. Basically, these pneumatic cylinders. I already have the blue plastic. I can create the cannon barrel pretty simple. This is something that I've already created. I'm doing the safety tube module. Blue plastic. So that is going to be simple. That's about the same. Yeah, so all of these are fairly close to the same. So I can go ahead and do that off camera. I'll probably go ahead and create the recipes for some of this. It doesn't make sense for me to do this manually. If I need to remove the recipes later because I don't need them anymore, I can go ahead and do that. But I'm going to go ahead and end it off for today. Unfortunately, I did reach that wrapping up point quite a long time ago, but I want to go ahead and thank you for watching. I really hope that you enjoyed it. If you could rate and comment down below, it'd be greatly appreciated. And also, if you like the series, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. But for now, this is goodbye.